Steve Burtt, born and raised Harlem, New York, been playing for the last 3 seasons over in Ukraine.
I just want to thank God for all the pretty women he let into my life, all the Benjamins he let me count, wealth and health for my family, and let me ball on these niggas.
I'm actually about to go into my school and play some ball.
And then I say church, we make it light up like a church. She wanna fuck and I say church. You live on Sunday like a church.
Bottle at the bottle, drink until I overdose. Pull up in the Phantom, watch them bitches catch the Holy Ghost. Every time I step up in the dealer, I be gone, bro. Johnny wanna fuck me, I say get on top and roll.
Getting inducted into the Hall of Fame is like a dream come true, you know. To do it anywhere means the world, just to be, you know, kind of etched in the history of your school. But to do it, you know, at my father's alma mater, and to have finished just everything that came with doing that, all of my accolades mixed in with his, to have finished first and second all time in scoring, and you know what I mean? And then for him to be in the Hall of Fame, and then, you know, me to come in there 20 some odd years later, you know, it means the world, man. I would have never imagined that I'd be blessed enough to accomplish something like that. So, you know, it's definitely something that, you know, I'm amazed by. I'm actually still amazed by it, and I'll probably still be in shock even after the ceremony.
Lane. Bitch, warmers never ride on, so play the game. Never drop the ball, never accept the loss. Get back up if you fall, and when your number call, you better give your all. I hope you give your all. You gotta play it to the end. The only deal between a winner and a loser is a winner plays until he wins. Ain't nothing
for- Ladies and gentlemen, it is with great honor that I introduce my son, the great Steve Burtt.
What inspires me and what motivates me is probably, you know, the same things for me. You know what I mean? First and foremost is my family, you know. Them putting so much love and support, as they should, as any family should, with their children. But to be able to kind of pay them back in happiness and you know, my success and things of that nature, that definitely motivates me to see the smiles that I put on their faces, to see them, you know, happy and cheering for me, and you know, me living up to all their expectations. You know, that definitely motivates me on a daily basis. My father, definitely being a basketball player himself, and me growing up watching him and him being, you know, my idol and my favorite player, he definitely inspired me and motivated me. And, coming late was the passing of my grandmother. You know, she was always motivation and inspiration for me growing up, and it just became stronger, you know, when she left us, because it was hard. It got hard to keep going and to keep playing, because, you know, she was like my rock. And just knowing that, you know, she's still there. She might not be here in the physical, but she's still there watching over me and supporting me at the same time. It just motivates me, because I know that for me to have kept going and getting better and better, it made her smile. And I know she's up in heaven smiling down on me. So that definitely motivates me on a daily basis.
Yes, I did. So I packed it up and brought it back to the crib. Just a little something to show you how we live. Everybody want it, but it ain't that serious. That's that shit. So if you gon' do it just like this.
Did you realize that you are a champion?
You don't see just how wild the crowd is. You don't see just how fly my style is. I don't see why I need a stylist when I shot so much I can
I speak Italian. I don't know, I just want it better for my kids. And I ain't saying we was from the projects, but every time I want to lay.
The surprise party, that was pretty good, man. They got me for sure. You know, I thought my mom was taking me out to dinner. She you know, was real adamant about, you know, hanging out and taking me out to celebrate. And you know, that's what it was. I didn't eat all day waiting to go to dinner with her. You know, and that's what I expected. I should have knew something was up, because she said she was paying, and that really doesn't happen. So you know, but I was totally expecting to go there, meet with her, and then go wherever we were going to eat with my dad. You know, just a real family outing. And to get there and to see, you know, to have it be a surprise, all the things she went through, from the cake, the poster, all my family being there, like, it was amazing, man. I definitely didn't expect it. I wouldn't have expected everybody to be there and everybody to show as much love and support as they did. You know, not that I don't think they support me, but you just kind of don't see it on a daily basis. So to go from not really seeing it to everybody there knowing about what's going on and everything is a pretty awesome feeling. So I mean, it got me for sure, but I'm very, very happy and I had a great time.
Think he did when he packed it up and brought it back to the crib. Just a little something, show you how we live. Everything I wanted, man, it seems so serious. That's that shit. So if you gon' do it just like this. Did you realize that you are a champion? When it feel like living's harder than dying, for me giving up's way harder.
Next 10 years, man, I'll hopefully see myself done, you know, playing. I'll be what, like 38. You know, if I am still playing, it'll be because I want to. You know, hopefully I'm not doing it because I have to or I need the money or, you know, something like that. I definitely hope to be financially set and kind of doing the things that I want to do in life. Haven't really put a pinpoint to what I would want to do after basketball, but whatever it is, in 10 years, I hope I'll be well into that and you know, God willing, having some success at it. You know what I mean? On a personal note, I mean, probably married, one or two kids, maybe, but definitely done with ball. My body can't take it.
Oh, we are not one and the same. Nigga, I'm fucking insane. Fuck is you saying? Yo ass been doing the same shit, not doing what you-